One of our viewers asked this question: how can I get 5% guaranteed yield on my money? We're going to look at ways that you can earn anywhere between 4 to 11% interest and yield. So stay tuned for the full video. Thank you for watching. This is Richard with Wisdom Investor. We're going to take a look at ways to earn a higher interest and yield on your money. So one of our viewers asked this question, wanted to know how they could get the highest yield guarantee. Here's the question here. All the YouTubers say I should invest. All I want to know is how can I get a 5% guaranteed interest on my money? The short answer on this question is you'd have to go through a municipal bond. You're not going to get a 5% guaranteed on a CD. You'd have to use a municipal bond, typically $50,000 to $250,000 investment on municipal bond, and you would need to hold it for about 20 years. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at ways to earn a higher interest on your money. We're going to start with the least risky and go to the most risky. We're going to start with the lowest interest rates and move higher. The first category here would be certificate of deposits through a savings bank. Right now, the highest interest you're going to earn on certificate deposits is going to be about 1%. Now, there are some high-yield savings accounts. One that you may have heard of is called Marcus by Goldman Sachs. Originally started out about a 1%, maybe a little higher, but they had to lower that over time because they couldn't maintain the 1%. So right now, it's about a 0.5%. So the next area we're going to look at is low-duration bond funds. You're going to earn a higher interest on these with a little bit more risk than a certificate of deposit. The duration on these go out to 0 to 2 years. They pay a quarterly dividend. This first one here, Vanguard Ultra Short Term Admiral, you could actually substitute that as a money market fund if you want to have money that just sitting around that you can actually get to. This is paying right now about 1.61%. It has a duration of 0.91 years. Minimum investment is $50,000. Now, if a person doesn't have $50,000 to put into one of these accounts, then you could use the Vanguard Short Term Federal, which pays 1.29% and has a little longer duration of 2.3 years. Keep in mind, as with all investments, past performance does not guarantee future results. A good place to get more information is Yahoo Finance. And you can check out all these funds and how they invest their money. The next category is medium duration bond funds that typically go out 2 to 4 years. And interesting enough, they do pay a monthly dividend, so that's kind of nice. But they invest in typically corporate bonds here, have a higher interest. You can see these run between 4.47% to 5.95%. And you can see here the duration. Still, I would call them fairly short term. You're not going to get a lot of fluctuation on your principal. Minimum investment here is $1,000 to $3,000 on these funds. And they're what I would call BB quality. Now, this next grouping are dividend stock ETF funds. So these are funds that invest in multiple companies. So it's basically being invested in the stock market. These also pay a dividend of anywhere between 3.7 to 4.91. They all have a little bit different characteristics and invest in different types of company. A couple of these do pay monthly dividends. As an example, we're looking at the XLE energy sector here. It invests in multiple energy stocks. Right now has a yield of 5.62%. And you can see the top 10 holdings on this are ExxonMobil, Chevron, Phillips 66, Schlumberger, ConocoPhillips. The next category we're looking at here is the preferred ETF funds. We have three or four of them listed down here that pay a little higher return on this, and they do have monthly dividends, which I think is kind of nice if you're wanting to get a regular payout. We're looking at some individual stocks that have a nice dividend, anywhere between 4 to 7.5% here. Keep in mind with stocks, they do fluctuate in the principal amount. Here's a look at Verizon stock, and of course you can see there is some fluctuation, and we also listed some various good data to look at when investing in dividend stocks. We're now looking at some what I call ultra high stock dividend ETF funds. Again, these companies invest in multiple stocks, and you can see the interest rates on these can range anywhere between 6 to almost 9%. Another nice thing is the dividends on these pays monthly. The next strategy where you can get a higher return is what's called a cover call or buy right strategy. These do pay monthly, and you can see the return on these can be anywhere between 6 to 11%. Now, one of our longtime viewers uses a covered call strategy where he actually does all the trading himself and gets a nice return on that. So if a person is using a covered call strategy on your own, they can generate a nice return. I know of several of our viewers that use a covered call strategy. But in this case, these companies do all of the trading for you. The next category here are floating rate funds. These are closed-end funds. They do involve leverage. They do pay monthly. You can see that it runs anywhere between 6 to 7%. So we answered our viewer's question on where you could get a 5% return. We also looked at ways to get a yield and interest of 4 to 11% on your money. If you have any questions, leave a comment. Stay tuned for future updates.